Tanuki powers activate. Oh, it's terrible! The king is a piranha plant! I hate this dance that he's doing. It's really annoying. Magic wand. There's a reason I use the Tanuki suit. I may not have played the ship very many times, but I do know that it involves a lot of fire. And you can't fight fire with fire in this game, so you have to fight fire with statue. Because we all know that fire's natural enemy is statue. You know, for the longest time that I thought that fight fire with fire didn't make any sense. Because, I mean, you know, you can't put out a fire with fire. I mean, what does that mean, fight fire? But I learned recently that it actually means something. If there's an uncontrolled blaze, like a forest fire or something like that, You can create a controlled fire nearby, and the controlled fire will eat up all the other fire's oxygen, so that fire won't be able to spread. Pretty neat, huh? The more you know. Of course, I'm not sure how effective it is, but it's something that they do. Man, this ship is just... it barely qualifies as a ship anymore, honestly. It's just... pieces. I mean, seriously, who would design a ship like this? Oh, crap. Maybe Frank Lloyd Wright. He designed some crazy stuff. Wait, no, Frank Lloyd Wright... he's just a regular architect. Frank Gehry is an architect who designs crazy stuff. Frank and Gehry. Gehry. There's an H in there somewhere, but I don't know where it's pronounced. You know, I think there's only one ship in this game where there's a question mark box after the pipe. And I think I know I already got it, because there's only one. Oh, this Koopa Kid is a bitch. But I got him. Don't worry. Cost me my Tanuki suit, but damn it, I took care of business. ITCB. ITCBY, the country's best yogurt.
Thank heavens, I'm back to my old Swedish self again. Thank you so much, here's a letter from the princess.
Yeah.
Oh shit! That's not the princess.
Yo, I kidnapped the princess while you were screwing around. She's here in my castle. If you dare try to rescue her. Ha ha ha. King of the Koopa.
You haven't heard him call that in a while. It's pretty old school. Oh yeah. In the tank levels, you go to the level as soon as you touch the square. You don't press the button to choose to go there. It's kind of like the Hammer Brothers. So yeah, most of you have probably seen this level. There was a speedrun a few months back that was pretty popular, where somebody used save states to play this level like a champ. It was pretty fun to watch. I don't know how I feel about tool-assisted speedruns. I mean, I know that they still require skill. A certain degree of skill. But I don't know. They're just not as impressive as, you know, somebody doing it for real. I feel kind of cheated. I mean, if they're upfront and honest about it, then, you know, that's okay. If they're like, yeah, I use save states, but this looks pretty cool, so check it out. I can respect that. But if somebody just throws a video online with no explanations, and, you know, that sucks. Let's try that again. Stupid wrench. Sticking a stupid... Sticking a stupid cannonball at my butt. Up my ass. Oh, I'm sorry. Up my shit factory. I forgot what the cool... I forgot what the cool word to use is. I'm down with the street slang, yo. Come on, this is pathetic, Duke. I'm better at dodging than this. Pull yourself together, man! You fat, bloated sack of protoplasm! So yeah, let's play Color a Dinosaur. Here we have dinosaurs of every shape and color. Well, they will be every color once we're done coloring them. Ho ho ho! Let's start off with their treads. They all make their treads silver. Yeah, that looks like a pretty good color. Kind of a silvery gray. What's this thing supposed to be anyway? An antenna? Well, whatever it is, let's color it gray. So it matches the treads. Man, these dinosaurs are awesome. They're my favorite dinosaurs. Dun, 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 dun. Big ass cannon. And I think there's a boom boom that I have to fight down here. Which sucks because I'm tiny. Oh wait, no. It's just a boomerang, brother. One of these things has a boom boom in it somewhere. Alright, this next level should be substantially easier. Oh damn. It's okay. I have a plan. I have a few tricks up my sleeve. An ace in the hole. What does that mean anyway? What hole? Are they talking about like their ass? Are they hiding cards up there? Because if so, that's a pretty pathetic way to cheat. Unlike this. This is an awesome way to cheat. Oh yeah. I'm cheating the hell out of this level. I don't know, if you pull cards out of your ass, you'd think that people would notice. They'd be like, hey, these cards smell funny. Where am I? Oh shit! Oh, there I am. Don't worry everybody, I'm okay. Watch me perform my death-defying... act of... swimming? Look at all those cannons I'm avoiding. This is the only way to play. And what horrors do we have to face down here? Yeah, there's the boom boom. Piece of cake. Easy as pie. Or maybe it's a piece of pie and it's easy as cake. And that leaves us with two directions we can go. We can go down pipe number one for another lock. Or we can go down pipe number two for the right way to go. Yeah, let's go ahead and do one of these. These levels are short. Fiery. Ah! Ah! close one. Boomerang, fat. Yawn. These are some meager challenges for one such as me. For a master of the Mario. Alright, I'd say that about does it for now. Tune in next time for more World of Illusion with Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. I mean Mario. Mario 2. I mean 3. See you later.